Hey there, friends on YouTube. My name is Roger with Electronics and Gadgets. If this is your first time here, thanks for stopping by. Hit the like and subscribe, please. If you've been here before, thank you. I'd like to do one on the new Samsung Galaxy S24 Ultra's AI capability. Specifically for this one, I want to do it on their being able to move things in pictures and delete things, reorganize things, resize things. Okay, so let's dive right in here. So let's get started. I'm going to go to my gallery, and I have this picture. This is a picture of my gym, actually, with the table. And there's a set of headphones and two water bottles. So let's try to do the headphones first. And the way you want to do it is you pick the picture. Then the icon at the bottom here, the little pencil, the edit icon. And then there's other things you can do to it, of course. You can change it, you can filter it, you can tones, some tools. But this is the main one we want to be concerned with, is this icon right here, the AI. So let's go ahead and tap the AI. And the first thing I'll do to demonstrate is, this is really neat. We're going to tilt the picture. So now, as you see in the top, or the left side, the top right, the right, and the bottom left, there's spaces that need to be artificially intelligently filled in. So let's go ahead and do that first. So all we do is we just hit generate. Okay, and now the phone's doing its thing here. It's sending the image to one of Samsung's servers, and it's doing it there. Now, look at that. It filled in. Let's go to view original. So there's the original. There's what it filled in. So what I'd like to really know is, how did that picture know that I have, like if you were looking at the very top here, how did it know that I had that when there was nothing there showing? So there's the original, there's the picture, which is really incredible. There's no way of knowing that I had red above that mirror, and that's exactly what I have. So this is really cool stuff. So there's the original, there's the handle, it filled that in, of the chair, as you can see here in the bottom right. On the left side, let's look at the table all the way to the left. It knew that there was white behind it, which again is probably based off of the white right here. So the AI is incredible on this. It's not like AI of the past, that it does some things neat and others not so much. This really is incredible. So anyway, that's one thing we can do. So let's go ahead and hit done. And then let's do something else here. We'll try to get one of these items captured. So we're going to zoom in, and I want the headphones. So we're going to tap. Now, I want just the headphones. So let's go and select just the headphones. Okay. So it automatically selected, it made it bigger, but I selected just the headphones. So now with that, we tap and hold it, and we can move it. We can resize it. We can turn them. We can erase, remove. We can, of course, return to what we were at. But what I'd like to do is, let's put them bigger. It's kind of out. It's not really true to fashion here, but we're going to make them bigger. And then there's where it was. And then we turned it. So let's go ahead and generate and see how it works here. Sometimes it does an amazing job. There's once in a while, every once in a while, it'll have a brain fart. But otherwise, it gets them. Okay. So like now this. let's hit done. And I want to zoom in. So look at that. It, the way it moved that, there's just some tiny light right around here, some fuzziness, but you would never know that those were that size and moved to that side of the table. Look, that's where they were, right in here. So anyway, that's some of the really neat things you can do with photos. You can move people's faces, you can do all sorts of things. And it's, again, it's with this right here, generative edit. Okay, so it's called generative edit. So I hope you found my video to be helpful. Thank you for being here. Please click like and subscribe to my channel. Leave me a comment down below. And until next time, I'm out.